A very good afternoon. My name is Alok Srivastava and I welcome you once again to Network Nuts YouTube channel. So, what's inside the car? Okay, in this car, like it's my Mitsubishi. You can see there I have got a performance air filter installed here. It's from the green, and I've got a custom headers here that will give me much more performance and that vroom that we all die for. So it's all and a couple of more things that I had fixed into this powerhouse. But friends, the video is not about the things that I have fixed. It's actually about the post fix. So coming back to the video, I'll share you what we are going to learn in this video. I am going to show you, forget that engine, that beauty, how to manage simple mailing lists in the postfix. So the prerequisite is that you should know how to configure a postfix server. That I think that you all guys will be knowing it. If you don't know how to configure a postfix server, then you better give the time and learn how to configure a basic postfix server. So in this particular video, I have got my trusted VM here, virtual machine here for you. Let me open it up. Here it is. So I log in here. Sorry. Here it is. So the basic postfix is running here. I'll show you. Main configuration files under etc postfix. Can I just make the voice a little slow or down? I think that will do. Yeah. Okay, under etc postfix you've got the main folder or the main directory that contains all the configuration files. As my basic postfix server is running here, I'll just confirm it. I'll just run the script to check it out. It's running perfectly fine. Let me make it like this so that it'll be easier for you to see the things. That's great. It's working fine. Now I have a beautiful picture for you to understand the concept of the mailing list here, and the picture is no doubt is being created by me. I'll show you. Here it is. Can you see the beauty here? Wow, I've got a really artistic hand. That's really great designs. These types of designs were found in the caves thousands of years back. So so actually no, I was not there in the caves at that time. So what the idea is that I got a postfix server. It will be configured by the root, and I've got a couple of guys here, say A, B and C. What I want to configure a mailing list so that if I send the mail, or I've got three guys, they can be 300 guys. What I want to do, I just want to send the mail to all of these. I can easily send the mail to a single person. Then it's of no problem. So what I want to send a mail, say a New Year wish or anything, to the whole team, and I have here 300 guys. So it is very difficult for me to send individual mails. So what I can do, I can configure a mailing list. Mailing list means I can virtually combine all my team guys into a single name. Say in my case the mailing list name can be team. So if the root or anybody here send the mail to the team, it will be going to all of the guys, those are the part of the team. So that is the basic idea behind the mailing list. So what to do to configure this? The default mailing your mailing list file is under etc aliases. This is the main file where you can configure your mailing list. By default the postfix will see in this file for the mailing list. Before I jump here, I'll show you. I've got a couple of users here. Say I've got a guy there, Alok created here. I've got RN created here. So I'll be combining Alok and RN into a mailing list name, say team. So what you need to do, my postfix is running fine. Let me check it again. I'll show you. That's great. My Dovecot is running fine. Dovecot, as you know, is used for receiving the mail for IMAP and POP. So I had already configured the postfix and the Dovecot. And remember, friends, I am running RHEL 6. So I'll be doing all the things on the RHEL 6. So what you need to do, just go to etc aliases, go to the bottom here, okay, at the bottom, say right here team, and then say Alok, RN, and you can keep on writing other guys' names. So in my case, I've got two guys. So what I had done, I had created an alias team, and if I send the mail to team, it will be going to Alok and RN. Is that clear? Now save and come out. And remember, whenever you do any changes in the aliases file, either you run new aliases command or you run post alias etc alias. It's up to you what command you choose. Now I again reload my postfix service. That's great. Now if as a root, I am root, sorry. So if as a root I send a small mail, I'm just doing a testing here, the Mitsu power, and I use the mail program, the mail subject is hi, and I send it to team. So if you remember the my beautiful picture there that I had shown it to you, that if I'm sending the mail to team, it should be going to ABC. In my case, Alok, RN, and if other guys are there. So I just send the mail. Let me check. And you know that the default mails will be going under var spool mail Alok. Sorry. Here it is. The mail comes here, the Mitsu power. And the same mail should be delivered to RN also. Var spool mail RN. Wow. So both the guys have receive the mail, and if you see there under the against this delivered to, the address is coming as team. So I have not sent the mail to an individual guy, I had sent the mail to the virtual list name team, and this automatically be delivered into the respective mailboxes of all the users. Those are the part of the team. That makes sense. Now let's complicate the things. So that is fine, I suppose. Now the thing is that what will happen if you've got 300 guys, if suppose I've got 300 guys or more guys, it will be very difficult for me to write all the names here. It will be very difficult. Alok, RN, then it's very like A, B, C, D. It's very difficult. What you can do, okay, I'll not remove the line, I'll just comment it, or let me create one more. That is not a problem. I say staff, say I here I give my team, and here I say include, say etc postfix, say my team guys or my team. What does that means? That whenever you I'm sending the mail to my team, please refer the file here, and the names will be listed in this file. So I just save and come out from here. And before you come out, it's always recommended to copy the path so that you will not be doing any typo errors. Save and come out. Now I create this file etc postfix my team and write the name here Alok RN. It can be some other domain names also. Let's say Alok at gmail.com or whatever. It can be like this, but I'm not doing it. That's it. Save and come out. Now because I had done changes in the aliases, I need to run the post aliases command etc aliases. That's great. And I can also do a service postfix reload. So in this case, if I send the mail to my team, that is the name that or the other alias or the mailing list name that I had created. If I send the mail to my team, again it should be delivered to all the guys, those are listed inside my team. Okay, what I will do here, in my team I will also put root, so the mail should be given to root also. That's great. I do a post alias etc aliases, that's good. And I can do a service postfix reload. Now let me check. I do it echo the Mitsubishi. That's, and I use the mail program. The subject is hi again, and I send to my team. Now it should be delivered to root. Var spool mail root. Let me check. The Mitsubishi comes here to the root. Cat var spool mail Alok. It is given to Alok also. And if I do a cat var spool mail RN, it should be delivered to RN also. That's great. And if you see, the address is coming as my team. That is good. That is good. So in case if you got too much number of users there, you can, instead of writing the names here, that can be a pain in the neck, you can just include the file and write all the names in this particular file. That is good. Now I'm going to show you one more thing. What will happen if it is a small company, that in that case all the guys knows each other? But if it is a big company, or if some user account is there which is now moved, or it's a fake or a wrong email address, say I give to postfix my team, here I write bogus. Now bogus is no user there. I'm just showing you what happens if you're trying to send the mail to a person who doesn't exist. So I write a name here, bogus. Now bogus doesn't exist. Now just for the sake, you can always give post aliases and do the service postfix reload. That's good. Now if I send the mail here, hello, echo no bogus user here, and I again use the mail program, and the subject is, say in this case, wow, oh, and thus it is sent to my team. Let me show you if you're finding it difficult to see. My team, that's it. So I send the mail to the my team. Now the problem is that it will be delivered to var spool mail Alok. Fine, because Alok exists, and it will be delivered to cat var spool mail RN, because he's the user exists, no bogus here. And it should be delivered to var spool mail root. Just I'll show you here, it is. But the thing is that the error message or the bounced back mail will be delivered by default to the person who has sent the mail, because I had sent a mail with the login as root. So the error message or the bounced back mail, look here, this is the mail that was intended for the root up till here. Now from here you can see there, subject undelivered mail to the sender, and it is by default postfix send it to the person who is writing the mail or sending the mail. So because I had sent the mail with a login as postfix, root, so root has got the bounce back mail. I don't want that. I want that the mail should be sent to the, actually it should be sent to the administrator of the mailing list, not to the person who is sending the mail. Might be root is not administering that mailing list, it's a huge company. So what you can do to correct it, or the right way, is that here write one line, owner my team, the name of your mailing list, and then say Alok. So here in my case, suppose Alok is the owner or the administrator of the mailing list, my team. So my team name should be matching here. So whenever some mail is bounced or some error is there, instead of the person who has sent the mail, the bounced back mail will be delivered to Alok. So let me check. I save and come out because I have done some changes. So I should be doing a post alias and I should be doing a service postfix reload. That makes sense. Now, look, here I am logging as root. And root is not the administrator of the mailing list, my team. Say magic error should go to Alok. And I use a pipe. I use the mail program. The subject is wow. And I send to my team. That makes sense. So in this case, RN should be receiving the mail. That's great. That's good because he's a part of the team. Root should be receiving it. That's great. And Alok should be receiving two mails. One, his mail because he's a part of the mailing list. And second, the bounce back mail. See here. Here comes the bounce back mail. Unknown user bogus. And if you see carefully here, the return path is very clearly mentioned here as owner at hyphen my team, because I had specified the owner as Alok. So it is bounced back to the Alok instead of the root, which happened in the last case or in my last example. So that is how you can effectively manage a large mailing list. One more thing I'd like to share with you in this video. You can have by default the postfix listen to the aliases file. Look, etc postfix vim main.cf, and if you just search here for alias maps, let me share you. Just do a couple of time next here. Here it is. Look, because of this line, by default you need to configure the mailing list in the aliases files only. I'm sorry, but you can have additional aliases files also. You might have one aliases file for a different department and one aliases file for a different department. So what you need to do in case you need to have additional your aliases file, just put up a line here, hash say etc postfix, say I give my I says custom list or custom mail list, and the same need to be done for the database. Here etc postfix custom underscore mail underscore list. So now the postfix will be listening or reading these two aliases file whenever you are referring any mail list. Let me check. So what you need to do now here, I just need to create this file custom underscore mail underscore list, and I can have one more custom list here. So I save and come out here. I go to etc postfix custom underscore mail underscore list, because it is my customized alias file, and I can just write here say Alok and RN. I'm just giving you an example. So whenever you send the mail to Alok, it should actually be delivered to RN. And or what I do here, let me create one more user here for you. Say user add Arnav, assign the password also. Okay, don't assign the password. So what I want, whenever you send the mail to Arnav, the mail should be delivered to Alok, and this rule is not listed in the aliases file. It is being mentioned in my custom mail list file. So I write here Arnav should be sending to Alok. So means whenever you send the mail to Alok, it is being delivered to the Arnav. It is being given to Alok, and it is not specified in the default mailing list file aliases. Now because you had done the changes here, you need to give post alias etc postfix custom mail list, because now the mail list is not the etc aliases, so you need to change the path. And I give service postfix reload, obviously that's great. Let me check if I send the mail to say magic of custom alias list, use the mail program, the subject is Hoo-ha and is sent to Arnav, but it is delivered to Alok if everything is working fine. Wow, that is great. Magic of custom alias list, though it is being delivered to Arnav, but it is being sent into the mailbox of Alok because of my custom mail list. So in this manner, depending upon the needs or your specifications, you can have different aliases file for different needs. So I hope you like this video, and I suppose and I think I'm a bit slow in this video, so I need the comment from the same guy that whether I'm slow or not. And thank you very much. God bless. See you again soon with the beauty of the Mitsu. Hoo-ha.